This tutorial shows how to conduct the chi-square test of independence and interpret the results. As a first step after importing data, I can create a cross-table or contingency table with the xtabs function. This gives me a better understanding of the actual counts for all possible variable and value combinations. I put it into a vector called ct and start the xtabs function with the tilde, the small wave symbol, and put the two variables behind it, separated by a plus. Finish with a comma and the name of the data frame. The cross table reveals that only two people from rural county have a driver's license. If you intend to look at the observed frequencies and compare it to the expected frequencies based on independence, I suggest using the cross table function of the gmodels package. Add the ct vector from earlier to this function and also expected equals true. To hide all the proportions of the cross table that are provided by default and to get a better overview, add prop.c equals false, prop.r equals false, and prop.t equals false. Now you can see that the expected count for rural county and the possession of a driver's license is 5.6, and this is well above the actual count of 2. The reverse goes for rural county and no driver's license. 9 is the observed count and 5.4 the expected count, based on the assumption of independence. Eventually, this is a good way to see where differences between observed and expected counts exist. In my example, you can see that the other cells show only marginal differences of around 2. In this table, you can also see the chi-square contribution, which is larger when the aforementioned difference is larger. Speaking of chi-square, the chi-square test of independence is shown below this table, giving you the chi-square test statistic, the degrees of freedom, and the p-value. If your p-value here is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, then null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis assumes no difference between observed and expected counts. Or put another way, the null hypothesis assumes independence between the two variables. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis. However, the chi-square test is only an approximation. If you have expected cell counts below 5, it is recommended to calculate an exact test. This one is called Fisher's test or Fisher's exact test and has to be added to the cross-table function with Fisher equals true. The interpretation is the same. A p-value below the alpha level rejects the null hypothesis of independence. After a significant chi-square test of independence, you can calculate the effect size and also do a post-hoc test to see which cell of your contingency table shows a significant difference.